Hello and welcome back to the Journey Through Yarn knitting channel. I'm Rebecca and I'm a knitter and knitwear designer based in the northeast of Scotland. And today I've got a slightly different video for you. Today is the 23rd of March 2024 and I am off to the Scottish Wool Producers Showcase in Perth. This is a one-day event. It's the sister event of the Scottish Yarn Festival. And it's a true celebration of Scottish wool and Scottish wool producers. All the vendors today have their own, either their own small holdings of sheep or use 100% Scottish or British wool. So it's a slightly smaller event than the Scottish Yarn Festival in September, but I am really excited and privileged to be going along as a designer. I'll have a pop-up in the afternoon for about 3 hours. So I thought I would take you along with me and show you what it's all about. This is the third year that the Scottish Wool Producers Showcase has taken place. This is my second year and I'm really excited and looking forward to it. So I'll take you along with me and at the end I'll wrap it up with showing you any purchases that I make. But before we get going, I thought I would share with you what I'm wearing. So I am wearing a dress which I picked up in a charity shop. It's a monsoon dress in a really quite vibrant green colour and I just love it. It's really spring and summery, so I thought, yeah, channel the spring energy. And I'm also wearing, which I shared in my last podcast episode, this is my Irene slipover in the Scottish Yarn Festival's Clan DK, and it's in the shade Tait. So as I mentioned in the podcast, all the colourways are named after Scottish clans, and this is the Tait colourway. So that's my knitwear. This slipover is currently in testing. My testers are doing such a fantastic job, and my aim is to release it at the end of April. So not long now. I'm also wearing my Fiorellini socks, which again I shared in my last podcast episode, and they're by Marieva in her scheme. So yeah, very excited, and come along with me to the Scottish Wool Producers Showcase. Thank you. the next day. I came home yesterday with the intention to film this little outro, this little summary of the day, but I was absolutely knackered. But in the best possible way, I was, yeah, it was such a fantastic day, and I came home and I was still buzzing from the excitement of the day. So I made the decision to have a good night's sleep, and then this morning, Sunday morning, I would sit down, chat to you about the day, chat to you what purchases I made, and yeah, it was fantastic. It was so, I love yarn festivals because it's quite, at times it can be quite an isolating hobby. I do most of my knitting sat on the sofa watching the telly on my own. So coming together with like-minded people and finding your people, I really feel like I found my people. Yeah, it's just such a heartwarming thing. And being able to chat to you all about my designing process and yeah, just seeing what everybody treated themselves to. It was a really wonderful day. I got to catch up with Aude at Bobbles and Berries and Vanissia at the Woolly Worker. Yeah, so it was lovely seeing them in person again and just having a good chat with them. It was also really nice to see there was six designers who had a pop-up in the afternoon, and it was so lovely to go around and chat to all of them. It was just a lovely community feel to it, and people who are going through similar things to you. It was lovely to meet Amy Palko. I've been watching her podcast for many years, so yeah, it was lovely to chat to her and see her new design, which was released yesterday. And it was also lovely to meet all the other designers as well. And of course, I will link them all in the description box below. They were so talented. They all had their little niche. There was fantastic colour work by Beverly Dot. Yeah, it was beautiful colour work. There was some crochet by Marta, who has a podcast as well, and crochet by Abby. She did beautiful mosaic crochet blankets and wall hangings. I wish I could crochet like that, and I might have to just like get myself a pattern and give it a go. And there was Callum as well at CS Knits. He does fantastic things, a lot based on pop culture, and yeah, he's so skilled and so talented, and he's an absolute pro at intarsia, which is something that I need to give a go soon. But yeah, it was a fantastic day. I'm still a bit on the adrenaline of how wonderful it was, and I had a lovely buzz about the place. But yeah, I would highly recommend it. I can't wait for September, and I can't wait for next March. So, what did I get? I felt like I was quite restrained, quite sensible in my purchases. I've got a lot of festivals I'm going to this year, but there's a few things I just couldn't resist. So I did the initial lap, which is when I took my video footage of all the stalls and kind of thought about what it was that I wanted. What I like about the Scotch Wool Producers Showcase over most other yarn festivals is that I love the colour palette, because it is a celebration of Scottish wool. There's so many like undyed, neutral and very natural colourways, and that's my thing. I'm sure if you watch my podcast, a lot of you will know that I love a grey, I love a beige, I love a brown, really kind of earthy tones, and there was a lot of that there yesterday. So there was a lot I was tempted by. But I made two purchases. So the first is this. I got two skeins of Balmerino DK. So they're 50 grams each, so I have 100 grams. This is Scottish wool. It's in the colourway Meadowsweet. And 50 grams is 172 metres. And they are based in Fife, near Balmerino. And it is the most gorgeous, soft wool. The yarn and the sheep that they have, it's an organic farm, and the sheep that they breed and use their wool for their yarns is the Scottish Merino. And I think it's a cross between like a Shetland and a Merino. So they can withstand the climate, the cooler weather that we have in Scotland, but it has the softness of Merino. It genuinely feels like Merino, and I was blown away. I couldn't quite believe it. And it says on the label that it is so soft it could be worn next to skin. It really could. I mean, I do tolerate woolly wools quite well, but I think if you have really sensitive skin and can't normally wear 100% wools, or yeah, this is it's so soft. So I got 100 grams. I don't have any immediate plans, but I would really like a scarf or something around my neck just because of how soft it is. Yeah, and the colourway, it's a very like an oatmeal-y. I think it's showing up pretty well on camera. Yeah, gorgeous. Very, very happy with this purchase. And I was chatting to the lady, I'm sorry I didn't catch your name, but the sheep that they have, this Scottish Merino, it has a really low micron count. Now, I'm not a spinner and I don't know much about the actual fleece and fibre, but by it having a low micron count, that's what gives it its super fine and super soft qualities. So yeah, and I cannot hype this enough. It is so soft, so, so soft. So I think I'll start with an accessory, a scarf most likely, and then I may have to in the future make a garment out of this because it's beautiful. And the second purchase and final purchase I made was, I got two skeins of the Lammermuir wool. This is their Simply Shetland DK. And it's undyed, but they've called the colour Licht. Yeah, so it's a lovely natural undyed colour. The clip is from 2023 and they are based in East Lothian, so not too far away from me. It's gorgeous and it's a really, I don't know how to describe it. It's a lot lighter than it's picking up on camera. I would say it's got more brown than grey in it. And again, it's quite an oatmeal-y colour. It's lovely and soft. I would more than happily wear this next to skin. Again, no immediate plans. I would like to maybe do a design with this yarn. So I picked up two skeins, possibly like a collar for the winter. Yeah, maybe some cables. This yarn would be beautiful with cables. Yeah, so very, very happy with these purchases. They're very similar colours. Yeah. So what else to say about the day? It was wonderful, and I keep saying that, but it really, really was. Eva, the director, the mastermind behind the Scottish Yarn Festival and the Wool Producers Showcase, and now she's got her own yarn brand as well. So she's got a lot going on, but she did an absolutely fantastic job at organising the day. It ran so smoothly. As a vendor, I felt so comfortable, and she did a fantastic job, as she always does. I actually managed to get a photo with Eva, and I'll pop it in here. So in my last podcast, I spoke about making two samples of my Irene slipover in Eva's yarn, in her Clan DK, in the shades Calhoun and Tait. So in this photo I'm wearing Tait and Eva has got on Calhoun, and yeah, it was a bit of a pinch me moment that it was wonderful to have my design in such a gorgeous yarn. And yeah, so here's the photo. What else to say? I'll pop in a photo of me at my stand. It was so lovely to have so many of you come over and chat to me about your knitting. I love seeing all your own jumpers and knitwear that you were wearing, so it was lovely to chat about that. And yeah, it was wonderful. I cannot talk highly enough of it. So the last thing I wanted to show with you, kind of on the theme of the wool producers, Scottish wool, is a new design that I've been working on. I started this in December, and then with all my test knits going on and pattern releases, it kind of took a step back because it just had to for me to have the headspace. But in time for the weekend, I'd cleared my needles so much, as you'll have seen in my last podcast, I took it along with me yesterday, and there's quite a lot of you were interested in it, and I was able to talk a little bit about it. I had no immediate plans for it. It was just a pleasure project for me. So it's still on the needles. And you would have seen me working on this earlier in the car. But this is a shawl. And it's worked from side to side, left to right. And it's got an all over abstract cable. So this is inspired. So when at Christmas time, we stayed in a lovely cottage in the Scottish Highlands in a place called Birichen, which is in Sutherland. And every morning I would wake up with my cup of tea and there was these big, beautiful French doors, and I would open the doors and I would look out. And from where I was standing, I could see these gorgeous rolling hills and heather, and just it was stunning. And then I would look over to my right and I could see forest, and you could see water in the distance. And it was just, from stood in one spot, you could see so much nature and so much beauty. So I was really inspired by that, and I wanted to knit something which had that kind of rolling hills, but also the same with for the water. So this is where this came from, and so this is the Birichen shawl. And yeah, the cables, the idea was to create that rolling hills, the flowing water that I could see every morning. So yeah, it's a triangular shape. So this side over here, this has been blocked, and this has been over here is unblocked, so you can really see how the yarn just opens and blooms with a good blocking. It's got an I-cord edge, which I really like. I love working I-cord, and I think it gives it a really nice structure as well. This is knit in Iona DK in the colourway Fired Clay. So it's a gorgeous terracotta colour, and I picked this up in December actually. From Ginger Twist Studios in Edinburgh, but it's lovely. I've always loved Iona wool. I've got a couple of cones of Iona wool. It's definitely a more rustic wool, but the story behind it is just so wholesome. So Iona is a small island off Argyll in Scotland, off the west of Scotland, and it's a the clippings every year they collect from all the different farmers. So it's 100% Iona wool, but the combination of wool does vary a bit. I think the main component is Scottish mule. Yeah, I think I'm right in saying that. But it's lovely, and every year the yarn is slightly different, just depending on, well, what fleeces they get and how the weather's been, if it's been quite a hardy weather, then it's probably going to be a bit more. It depends on how the weather's been as well. So it's absolutely gorgeous. I love this yarn and I love this colour. So I'm very close to finishing this. And I'll hopefully get it charted and written up and we'll see what happens. There might be a test call soon, fairly soon, but yeah. I think we were all saying yesterday like how tactile it is, like with the cables, and they're all over, but they're abstract and they're really simple to achieve. They're 2x2 cables and I personally don't use a cable needle for it. I just drop my stitches and rearrange them. But yeah, really excited to share this with you, and it was lovely to chat about it yesterday as well. So that kind of wraps up the video and brings me to the end. As I say, thank you all for coming along yesterday. If you did and came and said hello, it was lovely to meet you in person and chat to you. And yeah, it was an absolutely wonderful day, and I'm still on the high from all the yarny goodness. So until next time, happy knitting, and I should be back soon with another podcast. Bye now.